Assalamu alaikum students, how are you all? I hope that you all are doing great. Welcome to your channel Maths D1D2 Scientific Academy. Today our lecture is related to chapter 4, which is expansion and factorization of algebraic expression. Your book is New Syllabus Mathematics 2, D2 Maths. Okay, the O-level mathematics. I am going to explain your question number 9 of exercise 4C. Students, before starting the lecture, I will request you that if you want more help regarding your subject, then you can subscribe the channel. Okay, the question number 9 is, the surface area of each face of a cube is this. Find the length and the volume of a cube. We have to find out the length and the volume of the cube. Okay, students, what is given in the question? Surface area of the cube is given. Remember that in a cube, all sides are equal. So, the formula of the area will be, as all sides are equal, so length and breadth both are equal to L. So area of a cube is L square. Area of a cube is L square. Here you can write down area of cube. The formula for area of the cube is L square. So the area is given. Area is equal to, we can write down, which is given in the question. Area is equal to X square plus 4X plus 4. Okay, students, area is equal to L square, so in place of area we can write down L square because we have to find out the length, so we can write down L square. Area is equal to L square, so we can write down L square. So L square is equal to X square plus 4X plus 4. Okay, students, here now we will use the methodology which is called completing the square. You have also solved the questions related to completing the square in exercise 4B, so keep in mind that concept. Okay, and I'm going to explain you again. Remember that for completing the square, the first and the last numbers should be the perfect squares. Here this is 1. So 1 is the perfect square of 1 and 4 is the perfect square of 2. So these two are the perfect squares. So we can use the methodology which is called completing the square. And for completing the square, here you can see that here this is plus sign. So here this is plus sign. So we will use the formula A plus B whole square. So this is all the rough work. You will not write down these things in the neat work. This is something that I'm explaining you. I'm clearing your concepts. That's why I'm writing all these things at the side. So A plus B whole square is equal to A square plus 2AB plus B square. So now we will use this formula. We will write down this whole expression in this formula like this. So L square is equal to, here you can see that this is A square, so I can write down X whole square, A square, and then plus 2AB plus 2A is given, which is X. A is X. Okay, so what should be B to get 4X? Here you can see that when you multiply 2 with X, you will get 2X, but you need 4X. So when you will multiply 2 with 2, then you will get 4x. 2 2's are 4, and when you will multiply 4 with this x variable, you will get x. So what should be b? B is 2. So a square plus 2ab, b is 2, plus b square. And here you can check that 2 square is equal to 4, and here this is 4. So you have written this expression in this formula. So here you can see that a square plus 2ab plus b square is equal to a plus b whole square. So what is a? A is x, and what is b? B is 2. So a plus b whole square. Okay, students, so whenever the square is given and if you want to omit the square, you have to take the square root. Here you can see that this is L square and we just want L because we have to find out the length. So we just need to find out L. So for to omit this square, I will take square root. Here you can write down, take square root. So you will take square root like this. And square root cuts each other. Remember that square and square root cuts each other. So they are cut, just L is left. Square and square root cuts each other, so just X plus 2 is left. So what is length? Length is X plus 2 centimeter. So we have found the length. Centimeter is the unit of the length. Okay, we have found the length. Now we are going to find out the volume. Okay, students, in part we have to find out the volume, and the formula of the volume is volume of a cube is L cube. Area of the cube is L square and the volume of the cube is L cube. Volume of a cube is volume L cube. So here we can write down L cube as L and L square. We can write down this L cube as L and L square, because when we multiply these two variables, we will get L cube. You know that whenever we multiply the same variables, we add their powers. So when we will add the powers, this is 2 and the power over here is 1. So 2 plus 1 is cube. So we can write down L cube. We can break L cube as L and L square. Okay, students, now we know the value of L and we know the value of L square. The value of L is, we have found the length in part 1 and the length is x plus 2. Okay, ji. Now, length is x plus 2 and we know the value of L square. L square is basically area and the area is given. L square is given and which is x square plus 4x plus 4. So, L square is x square plus 4x plus 4. Okay, students, now you have to multiply x plus 2 with this bracket. First, we'll multiply x with this whole bracket and then we'll multiply 2 with this whole bracket. So, how can we multiply? We'll multiply like this. First, we'll multiply x with this whole bracket. So, I'm multiplying x with this whole bracket. Now, I will multiply these 2 with this whole bracket. Okay, now I'm going to multiply x with this whole expression or this bracket. Whenever I multiply x with x square, I will get x cube, because you know that whenever the same variables multiply, their powers will add. So when I multiply x with x square, I will get x cube. And when I multiply x with 4x, I will get 4x square. When I multiply x with x, their powers will add. Okay, now I'll multiply x with 4 and I will get 4x. Now I'll multiply 2 with this whole bracket. First I'll multiply 2 with x square and I will get 2x square. Then I will multiply 2 with 4x and I will get 8x. 2 4s are 8x and then 2 4s are 8. Now students, what you will do is you will solve like terms together. This is x cube. There is no other x cube term. So I will write x cube as it is. This is 4x square and 2x square. These two are the like terms because they are having the same variables. They are having the same terms, x square terms. So these two are the like terms. So I will write them together so that I can solve them. Okay, this is 4x and this is 8x. These two are the like terms because both are having the same term, both are having the same variable, x variable. So these two are the like terms. I will write them together, and there is only one constant, so I will write it as it is. Now we will solve like terms together. There is no other x cube, so I will write x cube as it is. 4x square plus 2x square. I will solve them. 4 plus 2 is 6. So I will get 6x square. Now I will solve 4x and 8x. Both are having the plus sign, so they will add. 8 plus 4 is 12. So plus 12x. And thus there is only one constant, and I will write that constant as it is. So student, x cube plus 6x square plus 12x plus 8. So this is the whole term. You know that we are finding out the volume. And the unit for volume is centimeter cube. This is the unit for volume. So this is your answer. X cube plus 6x square plus 12x plus 8 centimeter cube is your answer. Okay, students, let's revise what we have done in this question. Okay, in the part 1, we have found the length. And in part 1, we use the formula of the area. And you know that the formula for the area of a cube is L square is equal to area of a cube. So area of a cube is L square, and what we did is area was given in the question, and that is x square plus 4x plus 4. So in place of area, we have written L square. So L square is equal to x square plus 4x plus 4. Then what we did is we use the methodology which is called completing the square. By completing the square, we got the value of L, and which is x plus 2 whole square, x plus 2. We have found the length, which is x plus 2. So in part B, we have to find out the volume. So we use the formula to find out the volume, and the formula is volume of a cube is equal to L cube. Basically, we know the value of L and L square, so that's why we have broken this L cube into L and L square, and then we put the value of L and L square. We substituted the value of L, it is x plus 2, and then we substituted the value of L square, which is x square plus 4, x plus 4, and thus then just we just simplified, and we got the answer. I hope that today's concept is clear to you. Today's lecture is clear to you. Do the practice of these sums. And when you do the practice, then this concept will be more clear to you. Take very good care of yourself. Thank you very much, and Allah Hafiz.